Let's have Richard, who's an Arsenal fan. Good evening, Richard.
Good evening, Richard.
Oh, thank God for that. I thought it was the Tottenham show.
Yeah, listen, Arsenal would never be able to get Antonio Conte at their club, that's for sure.
Sorry for that again.
Antonio Conte would never go Arsenal, let's be honest.
Oh, here we go. He started with his nonsense.
Listen, we could have Guardiola and Klopp at Arsenal and it wouldn't change anything. Until we get rid of our owners, it don't make no difference.
Exactly. Oh, the Kroenke out, yeah?
Sorry?
Kroenke out.
Oh, he should never have gone. Listen, he's ruined that club. Between him and Wenger, they won't be remembered for what they done to Arsenal, but what they did to Arsenal. Anyway, Kane's going. Right, Kane's going. So if he's really excited about that, about him staying, Kane's going.
He ain't getting nowhere, mate. You're getting worried,
he's
aren't
here
you?
To burst
as
his bubble,
an Arsenal
mate.
Fan, going. You're getting worried. You're already miles off it anyway. Now you're going to be even more off it.
Wow. I'm not getting involved in this.
Listen. There weren't much between us, and at the end of the day, we both should be ashamed of ourselves. So that's the end of that.
Yeah, listen, we've got the Europa League conference, mate. We're flying.
Spartak with Dagenham and Redbridge. You can have that.
You're stuck with Mikel Arteta. They're going nowhere.
I know. And we could. I think we've got a really good chance to win the Emirates Cup this year. Arsenal, like, we can't do anything about Arsenal until we get rid of that structure there. They don't know anything about football. They're owned by Americans. Americans play football with their hands. I don't even know what they're doing at Arsenal. Right? But I don't want to talk about Arsenal, and I certainly don't want to talk about Tottenham, because it is just as bad a place as us,
yeah.
And you're going to see what it's like when Harry Kane goes, the same as when we lost Van Persie and all our other strikers.
He's wishing so much.
Go on, you want to talk England, didn't you? Let's talk
what
England.
What I wanted to do, instead of talking about has-beens, let's talk about England, right?
Okay.
And England, if they don't get to the final, I think England will win the Euros. All this talk, you're talking about, we might get the semi-finals, we'll have done well. Why? You tell me what four teams in Europe are better than us at the minute.
France, like Belgium, Portugal.
Why are Belgium better than us? Why?
Because they've got better players.
Oh, yeah? Do you think so?
Yeah, and in tournaments, I think they're better. They are. They beat us twice when we played against them.
France have got the best team in the world.
A lot of our games
will be played over here. Right. Currently, we've got the best squad of players in certainly in Europe, if not...
We haven't. France have.
Top five in the world, right?
France
all
have.
Our players, we've got good young players, right? We've got I hate to say it, but Harry Kane probably... one of the best strikers in the world, if not the best. He won the Golden Boot of the World Cup. I think he'll win it at the Euro.
Richard,
he's got. Yeah.
Do you think we're going around this again? Like, we're always saying we're going to win something and nothing happens.
You two are talking about quarterfinals and semifinals and maybe.
But hold on a minute. It's just history. I'm just thinking if we get there, we've got a good chance. That's all I'm saying. You're saying we can go and win. You're saying we could go and win the lot, yeah? Straight away. Just bang.
Yeah, that's all I can see. Listen, when I saw the crop of players that we had, do you remember our under-20s that won the World Cup?
Yeah.
Right.
Phil Foden and that.
You have a look at those players. You have a look at the players that we've got now. The kid at Man City, Jadon Sancho.
Yeah, Mason Mount.
They've been playing in the Champions League. They've been playing in the finals. Some of them have won it, right? The English league at the moment is the best league there is.
But do you think though, Gareth Southgate can be trusted with this group of players? Because watching that the other night, it was so poor to watch, so defensive. And I know it wasn't the first team, but still the tactics of it, I just worry.
Jamie, before lots of our games, like I remember before the Euros in '96 when like we were playing absolutely awful. Right, and like we were getting a right shellacking, and then they've been out drinking. And do you remember the dentist chair and all that? And they're saying England ain't going to be no good. Like it's always been the same before big tournaments. We start decrying what we can do. Right, we've got the best crop of British players that I think we've had since we won, since '96, since 1990. And I definitely think now we've got a bit of guard in that midfield where we didn't have against Croatia. Like we've certainly got up front, like. Up front with Harry Kane,
yeah.
With Raheem Sterling, who I still really rate, with Jadon Sancho, with the kid out of Man City, I can't remember his name.
Phil Foden.
I mean, what an exciting talent he is.
Yeah.
Plus, you've got Mason Mount. You've got look, there's a lot of really, really good players. A lot of
you know, one player that you haven't mentioned who plays for your football team is Bukayo Saka.
Yeah.
He's, you're not having him.
He's not even. You ain't mentioned him once. I think he's a real weapon for England.
He's a real weapon, and I'll tell you what. The difference between, like you said about Arteta, the difference between players like him and, like, this is a player with confidence that's been coached. Right, he's a natural talent, and I don't know whether I remember when we took Theo at 17 to the World Cup. Remember?
Sven took him, didn't use him.
Bakari, so he's the one you were talking about earlier on that can come on and change a game, right? That kid does extraordinary things in a flash, right? And he's got the confidence to do it. I don't know if he'll start, but if we were struggling, we needed a goal, you could bring him on, and with the players that we've got and with the midfielder that we've got, my one concern would be in defence, but that's another story. But I really think final or win it, nothing less.
The Sports Bar with Andy Goldstein and Jason Cundy. Monday to Thursday night from 10 on AM, on DAB, via the talkSPORT app and on your smart speaker. talkSPORT.